All right, welcome to our journey towards better text analysis. My name is Ashley Tang. So we start with latent Dirichlet allocation, LDA, but along our journey, we encounter several limitations. We'll explore the trio that powers STM, the correlated topic model, the Dirichlet multinomial regression, and the sparse additive generative model. Our main destination, the structural topic model. Lastly, we'll apply our knowledge to real-life examples, such as online restaurant reviews, media analysis, and also a new application. So let's start from the basics. What is topic modeling? Imagine you have a vast pile of diverse documents. Topic modeling helps us to group these, the content of these documents into several distinct topics. Topics are discovered based on the patterns of word usage within the text. So we could have cluster of word by topic, cluster of documents by topic. And diving a bit deeper, one popular topic modeling technique is LDA. LDA is like a librarian, but categorizing books without labels. LDA groups frequently occurring, co-occurring words like planet, greenhouse, carbon into topics and puts them into a bag of words. Then it assigns a book to a mix of topics based on its content. For instance, a climate book, climate change book could be 70% environment, 20% politics, and 10% economics. But LDA is broken in the sense of its limiting assumptions. It assumes uncorrelated topics, constant word distributions within topics, and also topic determination solely from document text. However, these assumptions can be very restrictive. For instance, in political news, topics like foreign policy, economic policy, and social issues often correlate. Word importance within the topic can also fluctuate with context. So budget may hold varying significance in personal finance, government spending, or financial planning. Furthermore, metadata like covariate, author or publication date can offer crucial insights into the document's topics, which LDA overlooks. So how does STM help here, you may ask? So STM leverages CTM, DMR, and SAGE, overcoming the limitations of LDA. And let's dive a bit deeper. So CTM, picture a web of topics all connected in some way. CTM extends LDA by allowing for correlations between topics, which is vital in real-world documents. For DMR, remember how we discussed the impact of metadata on a document's topics? Well, DMR introduces the power of prediction to our model by using document-level covariates. As for SAGE, it ensures the model's flexibility by allowing word distributions to vary across documents within the topic. Think of this as the ability to understand subtle nuances in word usage across different contexts. Before we move forward, let's take a moment to check our understanding. So how'd you go? All right, so comparing LDA and STM now. So in LDA, each document is viewed as a blend of topics where each topic is a word distribution driven by Dirichlet and multinomial distributions. However, STM advances from LDA's foundation, addressing its shortcomings. Instead of fixed topic proportions per document, STM models these, referred to as theta, using logistic normal regression, dependent on document-level characteristics, such as author or document type. Consequently, topic proportions in a document and the word distributions within the topic can shift based on various factors like document attributes and context. Let's make this comparison more concrete. Consider online restaurant reviews. LDA's approach identifies broad independent topics like food quality and customer service, but overlooks metadata. On the other hand, STM not only identifies topics, but also considers their correlations, adapts word distributions like fresh, rolls, wasabi for sushi, and crust cheese toppings for pizza, and includes metadata and covariates, and providing richer insights and more nuanced analysis. So now let's dive into the core theory of STM, using figure one from the original paper and focusing on topic prevalence and topic content. So topic prevalence represents the proportions of topics in a document. For example, a paper on climate change could predominantly contain topics like environmental science and climate patterns, while an economic article might harbor more policy measures. The premise here is that documents naturally tilt towards certain topics due to their inherent characteristics. Topic prevalence is mathematically represented using a logistic normal regression, where the dependent variable is the topic proportions and the independent variables are document level covariates. And the topic prevalence mu serves as a hyperparameter for theta, which are the topic proportions in a document. And topic content refers to the distribution of words within a given topic. The usage of words within topic can differ based on the context. So for example, climate change can be discussed differently in academic journals and newspapers. Academic writing might include technical phrases like carbon sequestration, while newspaper would use more everyday language like global warming. And topic content is mathematically defined using as a variant of multinomial logistic regression. The dependent variable is the word distribution for a topic, and the independent variables are word level covariates. And basically, the model conveys the likelihood of each word given the topic and covariates as a function of baseline log odds, excluding covariates, plus a term representing the covariate impact. Now let's discuss the process of estimating and interpreting STM model, which involves the variational EM algorithm. This iterative algorithm consists of two main steps. So in the step, basically, we computed the expected values of the hidden variables, which are the topic assignments for each word in the document, given the current estimates of the model parameters. In the M step, we update the model parameters by maximizing the expected complete data log likelihood, a function of the expected values calculated in the E step. And then the variational EM algorithm converges to an approximate solution for the STM model, providing us with estimates of topic prevalence, topic content, and the relationship between topics and covariates in the documents. All right, so one real-world application for STM is the media coverage of China's rise. STM has been used to analyze how global media represents China's economic growth. The correlated topics feature of STM allows the model to detect relationships between different aspects of the coverage, such as economic growth, political changes, and cultural impact. For instance, a specific news article might simultaneously discuss China's GDP growth, changes in their political landscape, and the impact on global culture. And it's a powerful way to understand the multifaceted narrative woven around China's development. So it's quite interesting to that. All right, so structural topic model also has an exciting potential in the analyzing vast informal social media discourse on health and wellness. And despite data complexity and language nuances, STM could provide distinct insights and apply to posts from platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and incorporating covariates like demographics, platform, and posting times. It can help us gain a deeper understanding of these discussions. It uncovers correlated topics such as diet trends and fitness routines, and shows prevalence trends amongst demographic groups or platforms. And anticipated findings could include the evolution of diet trends or how fitness posts differ by user age and location, potentially improving targeted health campaigns. So we've reached the summit. So STM integrating CTM, DMR, and SAGE models with metadata and covariates has proven to be a powerful tool for topic modeling, surpassing the limitations of traditional LDA. It's been applied to a wide range of scenarios, and more exciting use cases await. But your journey doesn't end here. If you're interested in digging deeper, you might want to check out the original papers on CTM, DMR, and SAGE. And remember, in the world of text analytics, STM is the master chef, cooking up insightful recipes from your text data soup. Bon appetit.